Anki is potentially one of the most powerful tools in a language learner's arsenal, but it can be a little bit complicated to get going at the beginning. This video is a simple and straightforward guide to getting set up with Anki so that you never have to do it again. I've made this video to be as simple and straightforward as I can. If you're setting up Anki along with me, be sure to pause, rewind, and take your time. You're only going to have to do this once. To navigate the video easier, I've added timestamps and links so that you can move around different chapters of the video. Everything you see in this video was recorded on a computer, which is what I recommend you do as well, even if you're only ever going to study on your phone. It's a lot easier to set up for the first time on your computer and then sync everything to your phone. Let's start by downloading the program. Go to the Anki webpage and click the download button. For those of you that are on a Windows computer, the very top option should be already selected, and that's what you should go with. If you're using an Apple computer from before about 2020, you're going to want to use the Intel macOS option, and then everybody else with a newer Mac is the Apple Silicon. If you're a Linux user or use a Chromebook, you're going to want to use the top Linux option. Now that you've downloaded the program, installing it's pretty easy. For most systems, you can just double-click on it and then follow the instructions. If you have trouble, check out the instructions for your specific device because each computer can be a little bit different. Once it's installed, open up Anki, and you should see a screen like this. We're going to add a few things that make the experience better. These are optional, but they are recommended. If you're only going to study on your phone, though, you can just skip this. We're going to Tools, Add-ons, Get Add-ons, and then we're going to paste in these three numbers from the description below. They make your learning with Anki a little bit easier to use and understand. Now it's time to get a deck to study. On refold.link/decks, you can see all the Anki decks that we sell. They're the highest quality decks that we know of. Each of them are handcrafted and come with audio recorded from native speakers to give you the best experience. You can also download some free decks from the Anki web community page, and there's a lot of pretty good options here as well. Wherever you got your deck from, you're going to end up with a .apkg file. This is the deck. If you bought a deck from us, there will be download instructions in the email confirmation that you received. You should be able to double-click on any file like this and it'll import directly to Anki. If that doesn't work, you can also click on Import File and then find your deck in your files and then double-click it. Make sure that the Import Deck Presets box is blue and then click Import. And there we go! Great! Before we start studying, there are a few more things that we want to check and possibly change. This little blue number here is your new words per day. If you're new to language learning, put it somewhere between 5 or 7, and if you've already studied a little bit of your language before, 10 is a good place to start. Now scroll all the way down to FSRS and make sure that it's enabled. This is a newer study algorithm that makes your review time less. It's great. And now the final thing is to make an Anki web account. This is also optional, but it's great because it means you can study on any device and you never have to worry about losing your progress. Click on the Sync button up here, and then follow the instructions to make an Anki web account in your browser. Once you've come back, log in with your email and password, wait for things to sync. This can take a while because it has to upload a bunch of images and audio files, so be patient. Wait for the little spinny thing to stop spinning. Now let's get your phone set up if you want to do that. The first thing is to make sure you have the correct app. On Android, this is called AnkiDroid, and on iOS, it's called Anki, not Anki app. That is a different thing. So make sure that you have the right one. The Android app is free and the iOS app is paid, but it's a one-time purchase and not a subscription. It can seem like a big purchase for just a single app, but it's worth it. Once you've downloaded the app, find the sync button. Click that and it should ask you to log into your new Anki web account. So put in your email and password and then let it sync. This can take a while. The number one issue people have downloading their decks is that they don't wait long enough for the images and audio to download. We recommend letting your phone sit, open, with your screen on, and connected to Wi-Fi for at least 10 minutes just to guarantee that everything is downloaded properly. And you're ready to study. Great job getting things set up. Studying is super easy. Open a deck and then click Study Now all the way at the bottom. Look at this card. There could be some special instructions on the card, but generally you have to remember what's on the back. Then you press the space bar, which will flip over the card, and if you were correct, you hit good, and if you were wrong, you hit fail. This word can feel a little bit harsh, fail, but it's actually a good thing. You're just telling Anki what you need to practice a little bit more, so don't think of it as real failure. On your phone, a lot of these are going to be taps on buttons or on the screen. If you want, I have a much longer video that goes into depth on how you can set up swipes on your phone to make studying a little bit easier. Now, keep studying all the cards until you see the words, "Congratulations, you finished," or something like that. This means that you've gone through all your new cards and all your reviews. This is how you avoid things from piling up and making your Anki experience miserable. The first few days are going to be very easy, but as time goes on, you'll have more and more reviews. So this is why we recommend you don't add too many new cards per day. If you ever need to take a break from new cards, maybe you're on vacation or something, set your new cards to zero for a few days. This means that you're just doing reviews, which is much, much faster. But I do recommend that you do them still, because otherwise they might come back to haunt you. Okay, that's all I'm going to cover in this video. If you want to watch more videos about Anki, which I don't really know why you would, I do have a 30-minute video that you can watch about how to customize Anki a little bit more for yourself. That video's down in the description. I hope this video was helpful to you. If you enjoyed it, make sure to like and leave a comment below with the language that you're studying. If you have any questions, make sure to join the Refold Discord community, and you can ask in the Tech and Tools channel. Thank you so much for watching, and happy immersing. I'm here to drop some knowledge, listen up with your ears. I got a language learning method, gonna make it crystal clear. It's called Refold, the game changer, gonna blow your mind. Immerse yourself in media, fluency you will find. Refold.